Hello friends, in this video I am going to do a very famous experiment, card coin experiment. The principle of this experiment is based on frictional force. The fundamental of frictional force I have discussed in one of my video. If you want to view that, click on I button. Friends, when two surfaces come in contact with each other, they exert force on each other, and that force is known as frictional force. This is a glass tumbler, and when I keep this glass tumbler on the table, I will apply a small force. You can see that after applying a very small force, this glass tumbler is not moving. Why? Because this table is also applying a force on this tumbler in opposite direction. So that force is a frictional force
or static force.
Friends, if you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. Press the notification bell to get all the updates as soon as possible. Static friction depends upon surface roughness, type of material, and the amount of normal contact force. If this glass is slipping on the surface, it means the applied force is greater than multiplication of coefficient of friction and normal contact force. If this glass is not slipping on the surface, it means the force is lesser than multiplication of coefficient of friction and normal contact force. Take a glass, a card, and a coin. Keep the coin on the card and place the card on the glass. Frick the card and observe. The popular explanation is that this is based on Newton's first law of inertia. Because we applied force on the card, so card moved, but because of inertia, coin will remain in its position and gets into the glass. But this doesn't happen every time. Sometime coin move along with card. So explanation because of inertia is not very much justified. If we see this with another angle, there is a relative movement between the card and the coin. When the card moved in the forward direction, coin moved in the backward direction. Because of that, a friction force works on the coin in the forward direction, which makes the coin moves in the forward direction. Through this mathematical calculation, we are going to understand that what are the factors which affect the falling of coin inside the tumbler. Assume that friction between the card and the glass tumbler is negligible, but the friction between the card and the coin we will take into account. We'll assume that card length L, mass of the card M, capital M, mass of the coin small m, and the friction coefficient between the card and the coin consider as mu. Force during flicking is F, and the duration of flicking we will consider as delta T. First we'll consider in case of card. During the flicking, force is on the card working in the horizontal direction. So we can write equation like this: F minus F into delta T will be equal to mv. This F is the force applied. Small f is the force between the card and the tumbler. That is a frictional force, which we have assumed as negligible. And delta T is the time for flicking. So when we assume this as a negligible, the equation will be F delta T will be equal to mv, and velocity will be equal to F delta T by m. The next we have to assume that movement in the coin is small. That is, it can be equal to the length of the card L. So the time for that movement will be S by V, and S is L over here, so L by V. Now in this equation, T is equal to L by V. In the place of V, we will substitute the value from equation 1. That will be T is equal to L into M by F delta T. So now we'll label it as equation 2. Now we'll come in case of coin. Since delta T is small, we can neglect it. So the next equation will be F is equal to mu into N, where N is the normal reaction force, so it will be mu into mg. The acceleration of the coin will be equal to F by M, so that will be mu mg by M. The M will get cancelled and we'll get the equation A is equal to mu into g. Till now we have got these three equations, velocity, time and acceleration of the coin. Now assume that distance moved by the coin delta x. So we'll use the equation of motion delta x is equal to ut plus half a t square. Since u is 0, so delta x will be equal to half a t square. Now we'll substitute the value of a and t from the equation 2 and 3. So we'll get that delta x will be equal to half into mu into g into L square m square by f delta t whole square. This whole value should be lesser than r. This r is the radius of the tumbler. Then only the coin will fall into tumbler. These are the factors which affect it, that is coefficient of friction, length of the card, mass of the card, force applied and the duration of flicking. But among all these, the most important thing is the delta x should be lesser than the radius of the tumbler. Then only the coin will fall inside the tumbler.
Friends, I hope you have enjoyed this experiment. Thanks for watching.